rise and salute Dr. the Honorable Godwin Friday, although he is not with us, but I know that he is listening. And his team, Honorable Sinclair Lickup, Senator Batiste, and all other parliamentarians who are here, all other party supporters and well-wishers, locally and those in the diaspora. It's a pleasure for me to be identifying with a party, the NDP, a party of integrity, transparency, and accountability. My brothers and sisters, I bring you good news. I want to let you know that better days are coming. And under an NDP governance, St. Vincent and the Grenadines will rise again. Every day, we listen to the numerous cries of the people on the ground. You know what does get me vexed? Just take a walk or drive to the villages of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and you would see and hear the untold stories of what is taking place. Sometimes it is very heart-wrenching to see the numerous young men and women just lying on the blocks, day by day, still waiting for the jobs that they were promised. Where are the jobs? There are many parents who have to juggle to send their children to school. People can't eat a food. Yes, my people, very high rates of unemployment exist in this country.
Where I am?
Many persons continue to receive contracts upon contracts, clogging up the public service system and robbing our youths of an opportunity to gain employment. This is highway robbery. There are a number of school dropouts, poor health conditions, deplorable road conditions, yet we hear statements that Vincentians are not suffering that much. This is a clear case of political Alzheimer's. My people, I urge you to vote for the NDP and the man who has a plan and an obsession for job creation in this country. Our leader, Dr. Godwin Friday. There is a frightening trend that is taking place in St. Vincent and the Grenadines today, where we notice that Vincentians can no longer differentiate between right and wrong. Justices and injustices in this country. They are staring us in our faces. Look at the wrongs that is being done to our teachers who have won their cases against the government. Look at the injustices done to our brothers, Marcus the Freitas, who has not yet received a red cent, but now they want to put big fancy building on his land. Bigger Biggs, who was brought to his knees by this wicked regime. The life of the business owned by our very own Honorable Daniel Cummins was cut short by some wicked bandits who choose to put party before country. When will we ever get justice in St. Louis? When we listened to the ULP campaign in 2001, we got the impression that our streets would have been paved with gold. Today, look at the roads. You don't even need a pothole diploma to see how many holes there are. The government boasts of an education revolution. Well, if you want to ask about education, ask Maureen Bracken. Many of our children are still falling through the cracks. Poor conditions in the schools, high rates of illiteracy and numeracy, inconsistent methods of assessing the teaching learning process, behavioral problems, I joke. We need sustainable remedial programs for our students. As a former principal, I can tell you that I became many times emotional when I see students reach grade 6 level and still can't read. My brothers and sisters, do you know what it is like when you can't read? I see big people cry long tears already when they can't even make out their own name on a piece of paper. Ignorance is definitely not bliss. We can't allow the system to fail our children at all. The future of this country rests heavily on the structures we put in place today to facilitate the success of the next generation to come. We talk about the availability of scholarships and training, but unfortunately, when our students return home from universities, they cannot find jobs. Many become very hopeless as they watch others unfairly fill in the positions that they are not qualified for, all because of political affiliation. Could you imagine that? An education revolution can only be good when it helps to strengthen all citizens in society. When all Vincentians can breathe again, and when equity and equality prevail across the education system.
Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds.
We hear talks about the adoption of a classroom project, where 347 primary school students are expected to receive checks and book certificates valued at $600. We also care about prime monies sharing away. Some of the persons who receive these monies are public servants. This is so unfair to our people. Why not put the monies where the pain is? Give some to the businesses that have closed down. Brothers and sisters, could all this compensate for students who are unable to pay for their CSEC subjects, or those who have become frustrated and ended up in the mental asylum? An NDP government would ensure that no students are left behind, and all their CSEC subjects would be paid for. The idea of technological integration into our school's curriculum is an NDP initiative stolen by the ULP. They took it and ran with it. But lo and behold, their style of implementation failed. It just could not remedy the social factors hindering our teachers, students from performing at their very best. An NDP government will ensure that the Ministry of Education develops a philosophy for optimum education in this country. Our teachers, students, and parents will be properly trained to execute what is required of them, including online learning. Why is it that all secondary schools in this country are not equipped with science labs, and all students are not given a chance to do foreign languages? Why is it that specialized teachers are not properly allocated across all secondary schools? Why are most of the learning resources not open after working hours to accommodate our adults and our parents who want to develop other skills? All these burning issues would be rectified under an NDP government. I cannot leave here tonight without mentioning about the sexual abuse of our women and children in this country. They have been abused left, right, and center. This is totally unacceptable, and it must stop now. An NDP administration would ensure that a sex offenders registry is established. As a part of the implementation of policies addressing situations of sexual abuse. A secured shelter for abused women and children would also be developed. So, my people, let us lead that march to freedom and prosperity in this country with the NDP. Make sure that you, your families, and your friends are registered. Go to the polls on election day and vote with a vengeance for the new Democratic Party.
Where are we going to do?